The Justice Department has dismissed the cyber libel complaint against Gabriela Pardilis Representative Arlene Brosas and former members of the Makabayan Bloc in Congress. The Criminal Investigation and Detection Group had accused the group of defamatory and libelous statements. The complaint was filed after the Makabayan Bloc members accused the police of red tagging and planting evidence when authorities arrested suspected communist members in November 2021. The DOJ, however, threw out the CIDG's complaint for lack of merit. Also included in the complaint were Gabriela officials Luzviminda Ilagan and Lisa Masa, as well as former Bayan Muna Partidist Representative Carlos Zarate.
The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency awards nearly 10 million pesos to its confidential informants. Video Chief Wilkins Villanueva handed out the cash to 11 individuals on Tuesday. They provided information for Pideo operations that led to confiscation of illegal drugs worth 9.6 million pesos, as well as the arrests of drug suspects. The Health Department set to submit pending requirements for additional funding of COVID allowances for healthcare workers to the Budget Department today. The two agencies met last week to discuss specific details and find ways to fast-track the release of funds. The meeting comes amid fresh calls to distribute the COVID allowances of health workers. In a protest held outside the DOH headquarters in Manila, the group denounced the still unpaid COVID benefits, such as one COVID allowance and health emergency allowance.
Teachers groups in the Philippines renew their calls for higher wages as the country marks National Teachers Month. Ara Perez is on the line for the details. Ara?
Ron, Teachers Dignity Coalition Chairperson Ben Jobasa says celebrating National Teachers Month will be more significant if long-standing issues are addressed to promote and protect the welfare of teachers. Basa said teachers have long been suffering from low salaries, overwork, lack of benefits, and the sorry state of public schools. For Vladimir Getua, chairperson of the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, honoring teachers should be more than just lip service. He hopes President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will implement measures that would increase the pay of teachers while coming up with an educational recovery plan and an overhaul of the K-12 program. During Tuesday's kickoff ceremony for the National Teachers Month held at Davao del Norte, Vice President and concurrent DepEd Secretary Sara Duterte expressed gratitude and credited teachers for imparting integrity to students, saying they deserve respect and admiration. The Vice President, who described herself as coming from a family of teachers, also recognized the hardships of teachers, especially amid the pandemic. Davao del Norte First District Representative Pantaleon Alvarez committed to join in efforts to assist teachers through expanded career options and training, just compensation, construction of schools, and provision of facilities. Ron?
Ara Perez, thank you for the report. Here at home, an infectious diseases expert opposes a possible lifting or relaxing of the face mask mandate, arguing it may send a dangerous message to the public. This comes as government still lags behind its booster jab targets. Let's get details now. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Pia Gutierrez. Hi, Pia.
Hi, Ron. Yes, that's right. Infectious diseases expert Dr. Ron Jean Solante warns that the Cebu City LGU's order lifting or relaxing the mandatory wearing of face masks in public places could send a wrong message to the public that the country is no longer at risk for COVID-19 and could potentially discourage more people from getting their booster shots against the virus. In an interview this morning, Solante reminded the public that it is not yet time to lift face mask rules, citing the continuing community transmission of COVID-19 and the country's low booster uptake. Solante is concerned that people would see Cebu City's order as a signal that they can already safely disregard minimum public health standards and that they no longer need to get vaccinated or boosted against the disease. He said that the country should still not lower its guards or be complacent against amid the ongoing pandemic so as not to endanger those belonging to the vulnerable population who are especially at risk for severe COVID-19 or death. He also urges LGUs to coordinate with the health department and their local experts before implementing drastic policies that involve the protection of the public against COVID-19. In the same interview, Solante talked about Legionnaires' disease, which has been identified as the cause of a cluster of pneumonia cases in Argentina. The infectious diseases expert says the disease is caused by the Legionella bacteria, which usually thrives in water or ventilation systems of buildings. It can also thrive in hot tubs, pools, or even air conditioning systems, and is usually spread through water droplets in the air. Those who are exposed to the bacteria may develop Legionnaires' disease, but individuals of advanced age or with comorbidities or the immunocompromised becoming more vulnerable for severe infection. Among the symptoms are cough, fever, body pains, and pneumonia. He says what happened in Argentina can very well happen here in the Philippines, so he advises the public to keep their water systems clean as part of efforts to prevent the disease. Ron?
That story from Pia Gutierrez. Thanks, Pia.